And I like it because sometimes they even send a crew to come and clean it and come, you know, mow the lawn and everything. Say, thank you for coming and cleaning my park here. It's lovely.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And when I go there in prayer, that's where God speaks to me. When His revelation comes, and He showed me His ways. When the battles are fought, where the battles are won, where He reveals the nations that are going to be added to us, and He reveals the sermons that should be preached, and many things. And I said to myself, if I don't take time to seek the face of God, how is God going to talk to me? We need to stop what we're doing. Turn out the TV. Jesus said, get into your closet. Close the door. And pray to your Father that is in secret place. And your Father that sees and hears in the secret place will reward you publicly. You know, that's how our connection to Africa came. I was in a time of prayer when I saw a young skinny guy, Kitololo. And I was carrying a Bible. And he says, you Christian? Yeah, you Christian. So we connected. In our first meeting, I saw the love of Jesus in this man.
Man.
And ever since then, it's been such a wonderful blessing. But I met him in a place of prayer. Like I went there to pray. That took it to the road here. Connection. Let's look at this. You are God with a basket of gifts. He's looking for you. Can you stop so I can give you something? You're all so busy. And then finally, when you get so tired, and so weary, he said, God, where are you? God says, I'll be here all the time.
Man.
Who may ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who may stand in the place of His holy place? He who has clean hands, pure heart, not lifted up his soul to idols, nor swearing deceitfully. And many times, idols, we think of images from a religion. Be careful, because there's things in our lives that can be idols. They can take. Whatever your treasure is, that's what your heart is. So make your treasure the Lord, and Amen. Your heart will be with the Lord.
Yes. Lord.
Seek His will. When you pray, seek the Lord's will for your life. When we come to pray to God, it is necessary to seek His will. Many times we desire things our way. I need it my way. No, is that going to be your way? It's going to be the Lord's way.
Right.
Don't dictate to God how you want your prayer answered. Don't dictate. He knows what is better for your life. Allow Him to move. Let us remember that as we approach God in prayer, and with faith believing, we must have the maturity to say, God, let your will be done in my life. When we allow God's will to be done in our life, things work better because His will is better than our will. We don't understand what's coming. He knows. Now, this is the 1 John chapter 4, verse 14. Now, this is the confidence that we have in Him. Confidence is when you're not floating or moving around, you have confidence. You are solid. You're standing in a foundation. You cannot be pushed. You cannot be moved. But you have confidence. This is a confidence that we have in Him. That if we ask anything according to His will, He hears us. And if we know that He hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we have asked of Him. When we come with confidence, asking God for Him to be glorified in our prayer, not our glory, but the glory of God, then we have that confidence that He hears our prayer. Now let me take you to fervent prayer. Fervent prayer is a prayer of invocation to God with sincere heart and giving, not allowing any room for doubt. Pray with all your heart. Now James 5:17 says this: Elijah was a man with a nature like ours. And this is what the Apostle James is taking us to see the life of Elijah. Elijah, the man that prayed and fire came down. Elijah, the man that prayed and locked the heavens. Elijah, the man of prayer that prayed and fire came and consumed those that wanted to take him prisoner. You say, well, Elijah, he was a special man. He had something. And James is saying, no. He was a man like you and me. He was subject to a human nature. He got frustrated. He was running away from a lady that wanted to kill him. He was visited by depression. He went into a cave running. He was a man. But he believed in the power of prayer. And he prayed earnestly that it will not rain, and it did not rain in the land for 3.5 years. And he prayed again, and the heavens gave rain, and the earth produced its fruit. Well, here we have a man. Remember back, he went to the king and said, it's not going to rain until I say so. Oh, hallelujah. When God gives you that authority, huh? When God gives you that authority. Okay, you know, when I say so, it's gonna rain. We need that confidence, brothers and sisters. We need to come out from that situation. I'm not able to do anything. So here we have a man, subject to passions, desires, like you and me, a man like you and me, but he dared to believe in prayer. And he prayed to God and said, God, close the heavens. And God closed.